Hi everyone, it's Elizabeth. Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is my take on a bad Sandy from Greece. I'm showing you how to get this hair, makeup, and costume. For the costume, all I did was take a pair of wet look leggings, a black camisole that I just tucked the straps into to make a off the shoulder, my black motorcycle jacket, and a pair of open-toed mule slides. Hers are actually red, mine are black, but I'm all about using what you actually have on hand so you don't have to spend money. So this is as close as I could get, and I think it turned out fairly well. Then her earrings were a very similar pair of braided silver hoops, and my cigarette, since I don't actually smoke, is just a broken coat hanger, which I don't recommend doing that because it hurt like hell trying to break that. Then I took my Rimmel Match Perfection Concealer and I used this as an eye base. This will just help cancel out any color. It doesn't really help extend the longevity of your eyeshadow, so if you have oily eyelids, I would definitely recommend going for a primer, but this works to cancel out some color. And I also used this on my face earlier. I've been garage selling, so I already have my base done. Then I just took some Rimmel Stay Matte Powder and I applied that over my eyes just to set the concealer and help it last a little bit longer so it doesn't slip and slide around. I take a Too Faced eyeshadow palette and this cream shade I use as a cheekbone highlight later on, and I start out by using a matte gray eyeshadow and I apply that over my lid and up into my crease. I was working off of photo stills, I didn't have time to watch the video and watch the makeup live as it were and in action. But from the photo stills I worked off of, it looks like her eyeshadows were quite dark throughout the crease and lighter through the center, rather like the new halo effect everybody's going gaga over recently. So what I did was I kept it quite dark in the inner corner, not my tear duct area, but the inner corner of my eyelid and the outer corner, and I swept it across my lid as a base, but I kind of kept up by my brow bone naked in the middle. That's the way the photo looked. I don't know if that's actually how it was, just the way the light was catching it, but that's how the photo looked. I also took it on that same brush, the same eyeshadow color underneath my lash line, staying to the outer corner to help smoke it out a bit. Then I just buffed away any of the harsh edges. And then I took a MAC eyeshadow in the shade Tilt. This is a beautiful silvery blue-gray and looks very, very close to the photo I was working off of. And I just applied that on top of the gray eyeshadow in the center of my lid and just kind of buffed it towards the edges where it met the gray. This really, really looks similar to what she's wearing and I love the effect. And again, I just went back in with a little more gray to blend that blue eyeshadow and that gray eyeshadow. And Tilt has a beautiful reflective sheen, but it's not glittery or shimmery in any way. And the matte gray, it just really blends and gives a good texture and color for what the photo looked like. Then I went back in with that same clean buffing brush and just blended it all together around the edges. Lastly, I took my face powder, that Rimmel Stay Matte Powder, and I just used that as a matte brow bone highlight to help blend away the gray edges between that and my brow bone. Then I went in with a black pencil eyeliner and a white pencil eyeliner. The black is by Rimmel, the white is by NYC. Any company will work. I used a pencil eyeliner because I felt a movie filmed in the 70s trying to recreate a look from the 50s probably wouldn't have been using liquid or gel eyeliner, and this was the truest I could get to look. And this can be a little bit more complicated in some ways because it doesn't give you as crisp a line, so you just have to make sure your pencil is really sharp and take your time. But it's actually more forgiving than a liquid eyeliner anyway, so it turned out pretty well. I gave myself not quite a cat eye, but a slight lift to the eyelid, if that makes sense. I just kind of followed the natural curve of my eyelashes up, but it was not a true cat eye. And it's kind of a medium thickness. It's not like a super, super winged look, but nor is it really, really thin. Obviously, that would be the definition of medium now, wouldn't it? Then I cleaned up apparently and I took the same black pencil and ran a thin line along my lower lash line. Her line on her lower lash line was quite distinct. It was not blown out or hazy or smoked out, however you want to call it, at all. It was definitely a line. Not my favorite look personally, but that's how they wore it, so that's why I'm going with the photo recreation here. Then I took a clean eyeliner brush to just smooth the line using a pencil and trying to get that final line. It can kind of get a little patchy a little bit, so that just helped clean it up. Then I took a white eyeliner pencil. Like I said, any company will do, and quite frankly, this NYC one's kind of crappy. It does not last a very long time whatsoever, but I had it on hand and got the job done. So, and it looked in the photo like she definitely had white eyeliner along her lower waterline. So if you want to recreate it, Not sure I'd recommend this pencil unless you really just want to spend about 99 cents. If so, this might be a great one. Then I'm taking the Rimmel Scandalized Curve Alert Mascara, which is a nice volumizing mascara and gives you really kind of almost false looking eyelashes. On me, it does tend to flake after a little bit, but if you were just dressing up for a Halloween party and weren't trying to wear it for like 15 hours straight, it probably won't matter too much, and it's super inexpensive. So just coat your lashes. You can use it, obviously, if you have a different mascara on hand that does the same effect, that would work just as well. Just give yourself a lot of false lashes in effect without actually having to put any on. Unless you want to, you know, it's Halloween, go for broke. Then I'm actually using another eyeliner, but I'm using it as a brow pencil, so if you have a brow product you'd like, I'd recommend probably using that. This just works fairly well for me, I don't usually do anything with my brows, so I didn't have to go out and buy a second product. I'm just running this taupe eyeliner from Rimmel through my brows to give them a similar shape as what Olivia Newton-John was rocking as Sandy, and fill them in a little, and I just made sure to comb through them. Because it is an eyeliner, it's very, very creamy, and this will help move the product into a more natural state. Then I'm taking a Bare Minerals blush. She had a very intense streak of an orangey matte blush. This is a very, very similar color, although I kept it slightly softer. It is still pretty noticeable and a bit more intense than I'd probably go for my everyday blush, so it's fun. Then I took that original creamy eyeshadow I showed earlier. I doubt she really had a highlight going on, but I wanted something because her cheekbones were kind of catching it, so I just used the eyeshadow. Then I went in with two lipsticks because I didn't have the exact shade. If you have a closer shade, obviously you don't have to mix two if you don't have to. I just didn't want to spend money because I'm cheap. And that's the whole point of these tutorials, how not to spend money. So I'm using a red lipstick. This is one of the Kate Moss ones by Rimmel, in the shade 10, which is a bright traditional cherry red kind of pinup color, and it's matte. So I just pat that on to give a light stain in the base of red color and smooth it with my finger. And then I took a orange lipstick, straight up orange, because the photos I worked off of, her lipstick was more of an orange red than traditional cherry red. So I just topped it with the orange to give it more of the shade and tone. And then I topped that, because it was quite a glossy lipstick, I'm just layering a lot here, I topped it with a translucent powder, the same face powder I used earlier, just to help mattify it down since it was not a very glossy lipstick in the photo stills. Now my hair is considerably longer and a different texture from hers naturally, so I got as close as I could, and I'm kind of demonstrating how I did this because I wasn't entirely sure it was going to work. So I just flipped it over, pinned my bangs forward to give some of those curls, and then pinned the sides up, and that is it.